Hello everyone, and welcome to another Coding Fundamentals in GML tutorial. My name is Sam Spade, and in this tutorial, we'll be talking about lists. This is a tutorial on one of the built-in GameMaker data structures. Data structures generally, as we mentioned in the introduction videos, are a collection of data values and the relationships between those values, along with the ways that you can interact with that data. One thing I want to note is that in these individual tutorials on the specific data structure, we're not going to cover the general data structure quirks that are true for all of the six GameMaker data structures, such as memory management. For that, you should watch the introduction, part one and part two. A DS list is a data structure that stores information sequentially as it is added. Essentially, it's the exact same as an array, but with greater functionality. So you have data, you have more data, more data, more data, more data. If you were to add data, it would be down here, and so on and so forth. Like I said, basically the same as an array, but again, with a data structure, one of the key parts of a data structure is how you interact with it. And with lists, you get a bunch of advanced functionality. Specifically, with a DS list, you can sort and shuffle, you can add, delete, insert, clear, and search, and you can get the size, see if the list is empty. And on top of that, you can use them with JSON functions. They're one of the two data structures, the other being DS maps, that you can use with the JSON related functions to load or save data in and out of your game. As you can imagine, this makes them great for any type of data where you want to sort it or shuffle it, or when you want the ability to insert and delete, and especially delete, because as we talked about when we went over arrays, you cannot make an array smaller in GameMaker Studio 2. If you want a smaller array, you have to create a smaller array and then copy the information you want into that array. With a list, you actually can delete things from the list. And they're also great, as I mentioned, for saving and loading. So let's jump over to GameMaker and see some examples. Okay, so we have our breakpoint. We are using DSListCreate. As we covered in the introduction, you always use DSBlankCreate to create the data structure. To create a data structure, we're saving that index to my list. And now we're going to add some variables to that list. So we've got my list. Let's view it as a DS list, and we're going to add these variables to my list. As you can see, they go in the order that we told it to. As you can see, they go in the order specified here. So 0, 1, 2, hello world, goodbye. 0, 1, 2, hello world, goodbye. Now, we're going to use one of the built-in functions, DS list clear. We'll completely remove everything from that list. And there it goes. Now we're going to add in some random numbers. 10, 5, 0, 10, 6, and we're going to use the DS list sort. Ascending equals true. So here we go, 0, 5, 6, 10, 10. Now we're going to shuffle that same list, 0, 5, 10, 6, 10. Now we're going to get the first value from the list using the accessor, which we referenced or which we talked about in the introduction videos. So my list, the list accessor at the 0 position. There we go, first value equals 0. As you can see, 0, 0, and 0. We're going to find the value 1. We're going to say, is that value there? We're going to say, what is the second value, or the value at position 1 right there? That value is 5, as you can see. And now we're going to use one of the helpful built-in features to actually search through the list and see if the value 5 is in that list, and if so, what position it is at. So it does exist. It exists at position 1, which again, 0, 5. You can see that that is correct. Now we're going to insert a value into the list using DSListInsert. We have inserted hello world right at the beginning. Notice how that just moved the whole list down. That's something else that you can't really do easily with an array. You can, but you'd have to write your own script for it, basically iterating through the array, growing it, moving everything over. With a DS list, you can do it with just a single line of code. Next, we have DS list replace. We're going to replace the last position, and for both arrays and lists, this is the way you can get the last position. You get the total size, which in this case would be 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then you do minus 1, because lists, like arrays, are 0 index, which means they start at 0. So as we mentioned with arrays, the final position in a list will be 1 less than its total size. So we get its size. We say minus 1, that's 5. We're going to replace this value right here with goodbye. There you go. It's been replaced with goodbye. Now we're going to delete. And like I said before, this is something you cannot do with an array. You can't make an array smaller, but you can make a list shorter. So we're going to delete the zeroth position, the first position, which is hello world. Delete it. It's gone. Now we're actually going to find the position of goodbye. So it's again, it's going to search and find the position goodbye. There we go. That's position four. Again, you can see four, goodbye. And if that position doesn't equal negative one, so dslistFindIndex is a built-in value, and it will return negative one if it cannot find the value that you give it. So if position equaled negative one, we would know that this value was not in our list. But it doesn't, it equals four. We're going to go into this, and we're going to delete goodbye from the list. So as you can see, you can actually delete from both the beginning or the end, and you can delete from the middle as well. Finally, as we talked about in part two of the introduction, we are going to destroy our list. Our list is destroyed, so we've cleaned up the data, and our tests are complete. So in summary, lists store information sequentially. You can think of them like arrays, but with greater functionality. And they're primarily used when you want to sort, shuffle, or have the ability to insert or delete. Again, especially with delete, because that's something you cannot do with an array. And the list accessor is the pipe symbol. As always, the links on this slide will be below, along with links to the slides themselves and the source code. And that's it. Thanks for watching.